SeaWorld announced that a killer whale performance show that took place this week would be the last ever at their parks. This move is the company's response to years worth of criticism being lobbed at SeaWorld from activists who've exposed the company's horrendous treatment of orcas in captivity, as well as public backlash after the release of the documentary film Blackfish. Tell us about this story. You know, SeaWorld, no more orca shows. We're done with that. We're not going to have these trained whales performing for your amusement. Take us through this.
It really did begin with Blackfish. If you haven't seen that documentary, really worth seeing. It just exposed to the people what sort of treatment these really intelligent animals were facing and how they were. I think the major thing, at least the thing I learned when I watched that film, was that these whales that we see at these enclosures, they weren't rescued. They weren't this, you know, some sort of orphaned animal. They were snatched from the ocean, from their pods, from their families who they bond to. They're very bonded, you know, cohabitating animals. Snatched away, stolen, and then put in these shows to perform. In response to the massive backlash, the massive boycotting, SeaWorld did decide, you know what, we're done keeping killer whales, we're done doing the shows, but it's been a really slow development so far. So they announced that they weren't going to do it anymore, but it was just now, and just in their San Diego location. They have three SeaWorlds across the U.S., one in Orlando and one in San Antonio, I believe, it's in Texas. They just ended the one in California. But they still have to end the other ones the next couple of years. And then the next thing to do is that they're going to create new programs for the remaining killer whales, which will be more nature-oriented, more oriented towards learning about their habitat instead of making them perform and jump through the air. They're also no longer breeding them. They're no longer capturing them. And eventually, the whales that they do have will die out. They're not going to release them into the wild. Some people would like them to do that, but they argue, and I believe as well, that those animals have been separated from the wild for so long, some of them have never been in the wild, that they would not be able to adapt and do well. They've tried releasing killer whales before, and it hasn't turned out so good. So I think that this is the best thing for them to do. I'm really glad they ended this show, and they should end the rest of the shows and just keep going towards their plan to completely end this, you know, unethical, immoral situation.
Right. And to your point there, a lot of the whales that have been released after, you know, a decade or two in captivity, they end up going back to areas that are filled with people, which is very dangerous for them. They'll show up in harbors around boats and engines. The whale from Free Willy, the one the movie was about, actually did that. I think somewhere over in Europe, it just kept showing up and wouldn't go away, and they were worried. So it is sad that they cannot release them, but it's because they screwed them up.
Yeah.
I mean, it's, you know, it's not the whale's fault.
Yeah.
But you know, this group, obviously, you know, what they've been doing is horrible, and I've never been to SeaWorld. I don't know what they have other than killer whale shows. So I don't know if this is going to end up shutting them down for good. As you pointed out, the other things that they have, maybe, I don't know. So
they have dolphins, seals, sea lions, things like that, lots of fish, just smaller mammals and fish that are able to be properly maintained in captivity. These whales, because of their massive size and their need for cohabitation, there was no good situation they were in. The whales that were, I mean, maybe the most popular physical feature of these captive whales was the fact that their dorsal fins, the fins on their back, would kind of fall over. And that was something that you didn't see in wild whales. And SeaWorld would, for a long time, misinform the public about things like that. They would say that killer whales lived to be about 35, 40 years old, when we know that there was, just last year, there was a killer whale named, I believe Grandma was her nickname. She died at 108 years old. Conversely, just about a week ago, Tilikum, who is the whale that is famous for killing one of his trainers years ago, and which was the subject of part of Blackfish, he died in his 30s just last week. So that part of it was a large misinformation on behalf of SeaWorld to try and trick the public into thinking that what they were doing was okay, when it really wasn't. And at least now they've caught up.
Right. And as far as corporate conduct goes, I mean, SeaWorld, what they did to cover this up, the misinformation, I mean, they're right up there with the Wall Streets and the Exxons. Mm-hmm. It was a corporate cover-up from the top down.
Absolutely.
I mean, you know, they got to the point they tried to send SeaWorld employees into these anti-SeaWorld groups and investigate them and dig up information. It really is a disgusting story. Blackfish tells it beautifully. There's plenty of articles online as well that do the same thing.